different possible configurations in a three-level inverter. Before that, I'll see what are the issues in three-level inverter. Each leg of an inverter. See how many possible combinations are there in two-level inverter, conventional three-phase two-level inverter. 8, out of which are 2 are null and 6 are active, 6 states, and these 6 states occupy 6 vertices of an hexagon. Are you with me? I do not know whether you are or not, but then it can be proved that 6 hexagons, sorry, 6 active states occupy in the DQ plane, okay. Okay, occupy 6 vertices. In the DQ plane, Q axis, D axis. Okay. See, I have a three-phase voltages VA, VB, VC. Are you with me? They are displaced by 120 degrees. Okay. Now, what I'll do? I'll resolve them along X and Y axis. Are you with me? I will resolve these 3 voltages along X and Y axis. Now I call them as D and Q. Are you with me? So I have a D and Q, I can get the resultant. Come on. I have 2 voltage components along D, one is along D axis, one is along Q axis. Can I get the resultant? Square of this plus square of the square root. That is the resultant voltage. Okay. So in one thing is for sure, this 6 active states, resultant magnitude of that voltage should remain the same. Now, are you able to understand or no? The magnitude of that voltage Vs, resultant voltage, should remain the same. But depending upon the switching positions, the position of the resultant will change. Now, can you got the idea or not? See, what are the 6 states we had? I don't know. Sometimes, S1, S3, S5. I said at any given time, one switch in each leg is on. Okay, 3 are null, 2 states are null. Remaining 6 are active. So what are the equivalent circuit? What are the possible combinations? One upper, and 2 lower, or 2 upper and 1 lower. 6 such combinations are there. Okay, whatever may be the combination, resultant voltage will remain the same. Are you with me? Resultant voltage will remain the same. What I'll do? I had a VA, VB, VC. Okay, what I'll do? I'll resolve those 3 voltages along X and Y, or D and Q. Okay. Now I have D and Q components, I can get the resultant, square root of that. So resultant will remain the same, but then position of the resultant will change. So it can be proved that, it occupies 6 vertices of the hexagon. Take it from me, such a, okay. The remaining 2 null, they are at the origin. Okay. So these are 6 active states, 2 are null. Okay. Now come to this. Now he has asked me a question. I can't be saying every time I can't. I will not occupy. In a three-level inverter, how many possible combinations will be there? How many possible combinations will be there? How many possible combinations are there? How many possible combinations? How 16? How many possible combinations are there? 14. But initially told me 27. Now it came to 14. How did you arrive at the 27? Total how many possible states? Forget about active and this one. How many? How did you arrive at 27? And that is an answer. I was a bit surprised. How many possible states? How did you get that 8 figure? 2 raised to 4, 4. But then how did you arrive at this for 8 for this? How did you arrive at this? This could be on off, this could be on off, this could be on off. This is 2 to the, this is on off, 2 to the power 3. So 0, 0, 0 to 1, 1, 1. 0, 0, 0 to 1, 1, 1. Okay, forget about it, we will find out. Let us not get bogged down with this. Assume, now see there are three possible combinations are there. In each leg, okay, either upper two or lower two devices are on. Phase A, take for example phase A, these two are on. Phase B, these two are on. Phase C, these two are on. It is similar to two level inverter. Which up, come on, when these two are on, A gets connected to VDC. Lower two are on. What is the equivalent circuit? Lower two are on. What is the equivalent circuit? Lower two are on. Where that B gets connected? B gets, see, I have A, B, C, I have connected, say, connected to the grid, or I have connected to a three-phase load or to a machine. Okay. A is connected to this point. B and C are connected to ground line. That's a negative of the DC bus. Which is this equivalent circuit we have studied yesterday. Similar to upper one device on, lower two devices are on. Hayana, this is the maximum voltage that one can apply in a three-level inverter. The moment upper two switches are on, what is the voltage applied? What is the voltage applied? VDC. S2, S3 on. What is the applied voltage? Lower 2. It is VDC by 2. So definitely to apply a very high voltage, or when I am at the top, which one do I need to apply? In a sinusoidal, come on. When I am here, what do I need to apply? Which vector? Come on, when I am here on top, which one do I need to apply in a three level inverter, upper two I need to apply, suppose when I am in the bottom maximum, which one do I need to apply, lower two, okay. So this equivalent circuit it's similar to two level inverter. This equivalent circuit is similar to two level inverter. Okay, wherein one phase is connected to the positive DC bus and two are connected to negative DC bus. Isn't it? Here could be S1, S2 on, here, S3, S4, S3, S4. This is equivalent to, now come on, this is equivalent to phase A connected here, B and C connected here. Okay? How many possible combinations are there? How many possible combinations are there? Active. 6. Null or 2. So here you just see here, point A gets connected to, sorry, one of the phases is connected to positive DC bus, two phases are connected to negative, or two are connected to positive, one is connected to negative. So these are known as large voltage vectors. Large voltage vector, entire this one is being connected. These are known as a large voltage vector. So I have 8 possible combinations. This such similar circuit is possible in two level also. I have 8 possible combinations, out of which 2 are null, 6 are active. So I get an hexagon. Those 6 active states occupy at 6 vertices and 2 are of origin. Okay. Now consider a case, when can I get this equivalent circuit? When can I think for a while, when can I get this equivalent circuit? Three level inverter, I have 3 lines. This is one leg of an inverter. The previous equivalent circuit I showed, S1, S2 are on, okay, S1, S2 are on, or S3, S4 are on. The moment I connect S1, S2 are on, A gets connected here. If these are lower on, A gets connected here. Something similar will happen to B and C. Okay? I showed you at one equivalent circuit. There are three lines. One is connected to positive bus, another one is connected to negative bus, and one point is connected to center point. Now you have to just recall the equivalent circuit. What did I show you? Abhi, memory recall should not take a lot of time. One line is up, one line is down in the center. When can I connect this? When this happens? Upper 2 are on. When this happens? Lower 2 are on. When this happens? Middle 2 are on. When point A gets connected to O, S2, S3 are on. Depending upon the direction of current, whether it will flow through S2 or it will flow through S3. Hai na? Theek hai? So, I have this equivalent circuit. One up, one down, one center. How many possible combinations? This is maximum is 2 top, 1 down, or 1 top, 2 down, whatever that I said is vice versa. Okay. Here is something here, 1 up, 1 down, 1 center. Okay, how many possible combinations? He's saying he'll take 12 volt supply and use a 3 level inverter. There is a flaw in your question. Why am I using 3 level? Why am I using a 3 level? Why did we go to 3 level? As the power level increases, the voltage level increases, stress increases, blah, blah, blah. 12 volts inverter, your one device may not be even turned on. Follow what I'm saying? prove the concept, you need to apply at least a sizable voltage of say 50 to 60 volts, so that some voltage wave you can get. If you are too scared of operating high voltage devices will fail, if you have that fear, apply a reasonable voltage of around 60 volts, so that something you will see. 12 volts drop is around 2 volts, 10 volts. Now two devices, will they turn on or off? I do not know. Okay. So A, B, C or vice versa, there are 3 phases. So how many possible combinations will I get? Here, this, how many possible combinations will I get? 6. A, B, C. It could be A or B or C. This could be, if this is A, this is B or C or A. Sorry. Yeah. And this could be whatever. One phase A, one. How many possible combinations? I have only 3 phases. All the time listener mode, not possible. Tell me, come on, how many possible combinations? I will not budge an inch if you don't answer. Sir, abhi 9 minus kidhar se aa gaya humko pata nahi hai. There are only 3 phases. There are 3 phases, A, B, C. How many possible combinations? Come on, let us, electrical engineer 6 or 8, it can't be, it has a unique answer. How many possible combinations? You have to find out if A, first combination is A positive, this is 0, then this is negative. Second combination is A continue to remain positive, this is negative, this is 0. Is there a third possible combination here? Not. Hayana, now what you do? B you make positive. This could be negative, this is 0, or this is 0. Negative. Over. So how many possible combinations? 6 possible combinations. 6 possible combinations. Is there another way possible? Is there any other for this equivalent circuit? Is any other way is possible, sir? Hayana, not sure. For this combination, it is not possible. So, how many possible states? 6. 6. Okay. Now, again, this 6 will occupy 6 states of an hexagon, but then voltage, the magnitude of that voltage will be slightly less than the previous one. Ayana, previous one was 2 top or 1 top, 2 down, vice versa. Here it is, 1 is in the center. So definitely it will be slightly less, slightly less. Okay. Now, what could be the third possibility? What could be the third possibility? What could be the third possibility? This is known as, first one is known as a large voltage vector, these are known as medium. So definitely if the large medium, then next will be small, small. Okay. Is it there? Yeah, here. 2 are top and another one is center. 2 are top, come on, 2 can be on upper 2 and 1 is in the center, or 2 2 center, 1 top, in the positive of, sorry, in the upper of. I have 2 top, 1 center, can't I have 2 down and 1 center? Ayana, it's possible. Similarly here, I can have down. Is it possible or no? How many possible combinations? How many possible combinations here? How many possible combinations here? Remember here, see, 1 top, 2 down. It can be 2 down, 1 top. How many? Quick. 8. How many here? How many possible combinations? And what will happen to upper, lower and this one? So, So what is the total possible combinations? Is this, 32. I'll just quickly say ABC, this is a conventional two level inverter. Something similar I can have 3 level inverter also. So I said A, B and C, similarly here upper two or lower one, lower two. So I have conventional 6 active, 2 0. So this is the equivalent circuit. This is what then analysis it does. What am I doing is, this is the equivalent of I am determining what is the magnitude of the voltage applied, the resultant A, B, C. I know V A 0, V B 0, V C 0 calculates. I am calculating V A and C. V A 0 is there, V B 0 is, V C 0 is there. This equation yesterday we derived, not in the matrix form. I may not have written in matrix form, but you get this matrix. So I know V A 0, V B 0, V C 0. I can get V A N, V B N, V C N. 3 voltages are there. So 3 voltages I can. Can I get V D and V Q? X axis and Y axis. Can I? Yes. This does V D and V Q. This matrix I'll derive later. Don't worry. This is nothing but resolving along X and Y axis. It's as simple as that. Which might have done in maybe in the 9th or 10th. I'm telling you. No jokes. 9th and 10th. I'm getting V D and V Q. If I get VD, VQ, I can get VS, resultant, square root of VD and VQ, square of whatever, okay. So you will get this hexagon, 6 active states, 6 active states, 6 active states. And see here, I know NN means, what it means is, N means negative bus. Negative bus, P is positive bus. This one is negative bus, positive, positive. This one is negative, positive, negative. What you can see, just cover it, the entire, see what happens. From here, how did I go? How can I go here? I had N and P. I just did for, I changed the conducting state of 1. See, N is there, P is there. The second one has become P. See here now. N continues to remain. This P will continue to remain. This P has become N. Only one switch is turned on and off. That's all. Only one switch is changing its state. Only one switch. How did I come here? See, P and P and continue to remain P and this N has become P. Only one. One has changed. How did I come here? P, P N will remain, this P became N and so on and so on. So this is the hexagon, okay. So magnitude of the voltage is the same, magnitude of voltage is the same. And see here, N and P, P, P N, complementary. A phase is on, B and C. Sorry, A is positive, B and C are negative. Here, B and C are positive, A is negative, complementary. NPP, C is negative, B and C are positive, here C is positive, B are negative, complementary, these are cis are complementary, okay. These are large voltage vectors, magnitude is C. Now you just see small voltage vectors. Two are connected in to the same phase, one is to the same, one is this one. So these are the possible combinations. Any two, A, B, C. This combination, two are to the same point, one is there. Is there a difference in opinion? If this happens to the positive bus, it can, something similar can happen to the negative bus as well. There also negative this bus. So it must be having, you are here. Okay. So how many positive, how many here? Three, six, six plus six, twelve, twelve plus six, eighteen. Okay. I'll come to this. Done this. How many we had? Six. Okay. So how many? Over. 24. Are you with me? Now 24 are active states. Now there could be null states. All of them are connected to positive bus, or all of them are connected to negative bus, or all of them are getting connected to whatever. So these are null vector. So active states are 24. So, but fortunately what happens is, though there are 12 active states, if you analyze, what happens is, the resultant voltage that I can get, resultant of this position of this vector, and correspondingly one here is the same. What I mean is here, see here, I did the same analysis I will do, okay. I can get one voltage position of the result. See, this is the resultant of the magnitude of the resultant. I can get this using two different voltage vectors. You want me to, should I prove it? Simple, nothing else. What am I doing? See this position, what is VA0? VA0 is VDC by 2. What is VB0? VC0? 0. So I know VA0, VB0, VC0. Can I get VAN, VBN, VCN? From that matrix. I get VAN, VBN, VCN, I can get VD and VQ. So if I can VD, VQ, I can get VS. That's all. It's as simple as that. So I can get VDF by 3, VBN by 3. So this one. Therefore I can get the space vector VS. So you can prove that. OOP will give you same thing. What is OOP? Two center, one positive. I can get same as 2 negative and 1 center, same. Similarly, so there were 12 active states, but I can get only 6. There are 12 active states, but then magnitude and resultant get only 6. So they occupy again 6 vertices of the hexagon, but then magnitude of the voltage is low. Magnitude of the space vector here is VDC, magnitude of the resultant is VDC by 2, magnitude of the resultant is VDC by 2, and in the previous case magnitude of the resultant, magnitude of the resultant is VDC of the voltage. And third, last one is medium, magnitude of the resultant is root 3 by 2, root 3 by 2, root 3 by 2, root 3 by 2, root 3 by 2. See the advantage that we get now. This is the hexagon. Don't get nervous, or sorry, don't get intimidated. Don't get intimidated, that's the right word. See here, large, 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 large hexagon, outer hexagon, okay? Inner hexagon, NNP over P, inner hexagon. Okay? If this is VDC, this is VDC by 2, center point. Another one was root 3 by 2. Now you tell me, you see, this side is the same, is an isosceles triangle. Are you with me? So what is this? Huh? Isosceles triangle, what will be the height of this? Root 3 by 2, root 3 by 2. And position, see, one thing, one difference is, these are large vectors occupy the vertices of the outer hexagon. These are small voltage vectors, okay, again occupy the inner hexagon, okay. Magnitude is only the difference, but then they are in same phase, but then medium voltage vector is, magnitude is root 3 by 2, but then they are in whatever, 30 degrees. So they occupy, analysis I have given, if you have time, go through it. By the way, any questions here? Any questions? Why are we doing all this? That question you should have asked me. Kyun karna hai tabhi? For what? Why hexagon ke piche kyun padhe? That's okay. Resultant vector. At the end of the day, why pulse width modulation are you doing? Why are you doing? Now let me talk about only about grid connection or something like that. This is the output voltage of the inverter, inductor, this is the source, okay. This is V1, V2, X into sine delta, okay. This is power is V1, V2 divided by X into sine delta. Okay. Now, if you want to control the output voltage V1, if you want to change V1, why do you want to, okay, if you want to change V1, what will you do? In an inverter, if I want to change the output, I want to change its output voltage, what can be done? Straight, don't go to pulse width modulation. It is just not obvious to me that to change the output voltage, I need to do pulse width modulation. No. See, I do not know, let us. That's the problem. Let us not straight away jump. See, off bridge inverter, the moment I close S1, what is the voltage applied? VDC by 2. Okay? I want to change voltage applied to that load, what do I do? What do I do? Ma'am? Yeah, I have to change VDC by 2 itself. Come on. If this is 100 volts, this is 100 volts, I can get, in the, when S1 is closed, I get 100, when S2 is closed, I get minus 100. Now I want to change it to 50. What do I do? What do I do? I will make it 50 and this 50. So in other words, I have to change the DC link voltage to change the output voltage. Make sense? Okay, fine, in the sense I will do that, but then here while I am doing, what is happening is I get something like this. I have a square wave. Okay, and if I take the Fourier series, okay, what all components will be there? It has a fundamental component and what is the predominant harmonic? Third, fifth, seventh, all odd harmonics are there. In a three phase system, this third harmonic will get cancelled out, then you get fifth and seventh. So if I am using this inverter to feed the power to the grid, and if I use this, what will happen? There is a fifth and seventh harmonic, predominant harmonic. Okay, fine. So to change the output voltage, I need to change the DC link itself. Okay. Then another thing is, and here since each device is conducting for 180 degrees, predominant harmonic is fifth, in here is third and whatever, whatever. Now instead, what I will do is, I will keep this DC link voltage constant. I will not change it. Okay. Instead of allowing this device to conduct for 180 degrees, I will turn on off several times. Follow what I am saying? What did I do? What you told me to change this output voltage, this madam told me that you change the DC link itself. It is, which is, looks very obvious to me, yes. To change this magnitude, I will change this. Okay? Fine, very easy. I have to change the DC link voltage. But okay, fine, in that case, but then this has a lower order harmonics, third, fifth, seventh, or all things. Second option I have is, I'll keep this constant at a very high value. If I want to change the voltage, I will not allow it to remain on for the entire period. I will on off I will do. So pulse width modulation you do for voltage control, not to eliminate harmonics. Now it so happens that if you switch at proper instance, you will eliminate harmonics. Remember, you do pulse width modulation for voltage control, and you suitably switch them, you can eliminate harmonics. So that's what we are doing. We are doing pulse width modulation to eliminate the harmonics. Otherwise, to eliminate fifth and seventh is going to be you have to order second order filter, size increases, whatnot. So henceforth, we will be doing only pulse width modulation. We will not do anything to the DC link. Okay. Now there are various pulse width modulations. Sinusoidal we know. Okay, and very popular is, asked any power system engineer, he'll talk about space vector PWM technique. Space vector PWM technique. So let me not. So if you see here, see the magnitude of the voltage changes. I want to change the. So I may be anywhere between in this hexagon. Are you with me? If I want to increase a very high voltage, maybe I will use these vectors. If I want a low voltage, what will I do? I'm inner hexagons. Okay. Take any hexagon. See here, I have taken one sector, 60 degrees. Whatever is there, I have copied. Same thing, whatever. NNP, NPP, NOP, and those three. These are null vectors. All are on, all are off, or all are this. Okay. See, NNP, NPP, whatever. This is the resultant voltage that you want. Are you with me? Come on, this is the capability of the inverter, like capability curve of synchronous machine. You have heard or no? Have you heard about capability curve of synchronous machine? Electrical engineering, you have heard. So these are the possible vectors of the inverter. and magnitude of voltage you want to control now. Are you with me? Magnitude of the voltage vector. So this could be the magnitude of voltage that you want, or it could be, I may be here if the length of the vector, I may be in this triangle, I may be in this triangle, or I may be in this, maybe in this smaller triangle as well. You take any triangle, see the sides of those three triangles, what you find? Theek hai, equilateral chhod do, but other than that, what you can find out? What you can infer? No, you can, you should be able to find out. Be any triangle, what you can find out from those, not triangle, outer triangles, smaller triangles, what you can infer? You can, that observation I, we have already made, is that same observation is valid here? You be anywhere, see here, if you are here, it is O over P. Suppose, see, I can get this using O over P or NNO. Assuming that I am in NNO, I can come here, I can come here by making N to O. If I am having, if I emulated this by using O over P, I can come here by making O PP. Suppose I am here. See now, it's the same thing. Anywhere, or if you are in this vector, NNP, here I'll come to NOP, and here, from here to here, you just see this triangle. NNP, NOP, here. Dekhiye na, ye triangle mein kya ho raha hai? Three vertices. NNP, or NNO, NNP, O to P, here. N to O, here, O, O, if I add O, O, P, no, N and O, N and O, P, N, O, P, yeah. So every time, one, I can go from one vertex to another vertex by changing the conducting state of only one device. So the problem in, is that okay? Any questions? Feel free, please. Ma'am, Pune. You saying easy, you are saying not easy. Now what stand will I take? What stand will I take? In life which you think which is easy, logically it is difficult to implement. Conventional two-level inverter, space vector PWM technique is so popular. If you see the expressions, they become very simple to implement. And there are DSP processors have a dedicated pins which gives the output signals. Are you with me? If you derive, I do not, if a soap opera should have told me, I would have come prepared, I would have brought that lecture. Space vector PWM technique, what is that PWM technique? The expressions, time for which I should be here, time for which I should be here, if you see, expressions are very simple. Very simple to implement, very simple to implement, okay. That is the reason there are dedicated, there are processors with dedicated pins. Now you will find bit time to understand this PWM technique, but then I do not think you took time to understand this PWM technique. Which one? Sine versus triangular. I am asking you to implement on a microcontroller. Now you are nodding your head. Have you implemented? How did you derive? What did you do? What you have 99% what you have done is you have generated a sine wave, okay? You have generated a sine wave, you have generated a triangular wave using a functional IC. You everything in a microprocessor? No, lookup table in sine wave, okay, but how did you implement this PWM technique? This PWM technique is sine versus triangle, compare, and here you get pulses. Are you with me? To get these pulses in space vector PWM technique, I have to implement very simple equations, very simple equations, very simple equations, very simple equations. Now I want you to do And you say that it is difficult because it is not, and whereas sine versus triangle is very simple to understand. Are you with me? Very simple to understand. I am asking you, have you implemented this sine triangle in a DSP, in a processor or microcontroller? I want the pulses. Have you implemented? What you have to do is you have to generate a sine, you have to generate a triangle inside, compare it inside, not outside. Why sine wave is so popular is there are dedicated chips which generate sine, which generates triangular, you compare it using op amp and get the pulses. If you have to do everything inside, this is extremely difficult, extremely difficult. Generating PWM signals using sine triangle in a microcontroller is more difficult than generating PWM signals using space vector. There are DSP, dedicated DSP processor, TMS 320 F240, there are dedicated, which are there used for drives application, they have dedicated pins. You have to just give the modulation index on the time it will give. See, there is no unique answer, sir. You have to do some cost benefit analysis, then you have to decide and you have to justify. Someone can challenge me, no, but you may be wrong. I may be wrong, I accept. In engineering, I don't think you have an unique answer. Before? No. There are literature is available. Japanese have inserted. They have gone up to 31 or 33 level. They're there. See, in 3 level itself, there are a lot of problems. I have not come to that level. There are drives, 3 level ABB is using. Any other question? I have VABBBC. Okay, what is the locus of VS? I have VABBBC, I'll get D and Q. Are you with me? Then I'll get VS. Okay, I want the locus of VS. If VABBBC are sinusoidal, what is the locus of VS for 360 degrees? VABBBC are pure sinusoid. Pure sinusoid, VABBBC, circle, okay, this is a circle. Now, what is the diameter, what is the radius of the circle, okay, what is the radius of the incircling circle for this hexagon? BDC karega to, incircling circle, this is the radius. Now beyond, if you try to increase the modulation index beyond that, I am going out of the circle. So my voltages are no longer sinusoid, VABBBC. See, you are asking a question, you are going, so it may not be possible to answer. First of all, you need to find out, so incircling circle diameter or radius, if my modulation index within that, it is sinusoid. If I am trying to go outside, my voltage VABBBCR may not be sinusoid, they are not sinusoid. Yeah, any other question? Feel free. Quick. See, the problem in multilevel is not PWM technique, the problem in multilevel is, now you need to tell me. Yeah, I want to discuss only this in multi-level. Since you asked, I came here, otherwise I would not have discussed. What you can infer? Now you need to tell me. See this equivalent circuit. This equivalent circuit and this equivalent circuit. Is there a problem? Three equivalent circuit, observe, please. This is an equivalent circuit. This is another one. Equivalent circuit. These are large voltage vectors. The medium voltage vectors, these are small voltage vectors. Oh, I have to divide this and I will wind up fast. Okay, what you can observe? What you can observe? Magnitude is varying, that you want. That is, you want to model, you want to change the output voltage. What you can imagine? What you can imagine? You see here, you are, see the problem here, capacitor is connected across the load, both C1 and C2. You are charging, and this is the discharge path. Okay? So here also is the same. Now you see here, this is the external source charging the capacitor. This is discharging, this is also discharging. Now you see here, when I am in this mode, one capacitor is just charging, another capacitor is both. So it will so happen that capacitor voltages may be unbalanced. The voltage may not be the same, See here, this is continuous charge, but only this is discharging, So capacitor voltage balancing is an issue in three phase, in a multi-level inverter. Capacitor voltage balancing. Now you have to monitor the capacitor voltages. If this is getting overcharged, remove the charge and dump it in this. Come on. It will, so if I am applying low voltages when I am in this, so what happens? It will so happen that this will completely discharge and this will charge. You can't, now what will happen? Capacitor voltages are unbalanced, that will affect your output voltage waveform. Come on, what is the magnitude of the voltage applied here now? Huh? It depends on this voltage, isn't it? This is no longer VDC by 2. This is no longer VDC by 2. It could be anything because this is VDC. So this voltage you are applying, this appears at the output. Now I may not get a symmetrical waveform, the positive of and negative of. So what you need to do is, you have to continuously monitor the voltages. If this is getting overcharged, what do I need to do? Extract the charge and give it to a other capacitor. If one capacitor is charging, another one is discharging, what do you do? Now how to do, I am not asking here. What do you do? I have two capacitors connected in C. There are, one is getting charged, another one is getting discharged. What is to be done? One is charging, the voltage across the capacitor higher than another one. I want to make it equal. What do I do? Extract the charge from the capacitor which is overcharged and give it to the capacitor which voltage is low. How to do? Don't worry. Don't worry how to do it. This is to be done. Yeah, cascaded multilevel. Just 5 minutes are there, I will wind up and go. Cascaded multilevel, just see. What was the problem in diode clamp? As the number of level increases, power circuit configuration also changed. As the number of levels change, what will happen? Power circuit configuration also change. Connecting the diode across the capacitor becomes a problem. Now what do you do? See here. What is this? Single phase? Single phase, the full bridge, Deco connection. So I need to have four full bridges for one leg. Okay? Are you with me? Now what this could be, this voltage? What are the possible ways what voltage I can have? Full bridge. What voltage ways do I can have? Full bridge inverter, what this voltage could be, man? When S1, these two are on, it is VDC. If these two are on, either zero. If this is on and this is on, this voltage is? A is here, this is here, what is the voltage? VDC. If this is also on and this is also on, what is that voltage? Zero. That's all. There are only two possibilities, no more. VDC 0, VDC 0, VDC 0, VDC 0. So if this is VDC, 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 what is the output voltage? 4 VDC. So here, 4 VDC. See the phase shift. VC 4. This could be VC 4. For this period, it is on. Okay? After some time. So during this period, VC 3 is 0. This is also 0. And here it is VDC. For in this zone, output voltage of VC2 is 0. In this zone, it is VDC. And here in this zone, 0. In this zone, small zone, it is VDC. Add them up. What do you get? 4 VDC, stepped wave. Stepped wave, cascade and multilevel, cascade and multilevel, inventory low, everything is low, could be a solution for solar, could be a solution for solar. Any questions?
For that two level, three level is possible for each one.
Two level, three level means?
Instead of two switches in one leg, four switches like that.
What is four switches? This is a single phase inverter. This is a what? This box, full bridge. What are the voltage levels? Full bridge. Now we did three. What is that? Three level, four level. Now I am in single phase bridge. What is the possible output voltage can I get? Zero or magnitude VDC. I can get plus or minus VDC, because if this is on and this is off, this point gets positive and whatever. Are you with me? So this voltage can be either magnitude is VDC or zero. That's all. This is also VDC or zero, VDC or zero, VDC or zero. All are zero, only this is VDC. Now these two VDC, VDC, these are zeros.
Sir, instead of four set of configuration, with two sets, three level
you can. That I do not know. Now that you invent, no problem. He is saying he wants to use only two bridges and he wants how many levels? I don't know. Take a paper and a pencil and draw. You have a paper and a pencil. Now you have only two bridges. You know how it works. This voltage could be VDC, this is also VDC. VDC 0, VDC 0, how many you can get? You may be having only these two, VDC, VDC, right, tuk tuk. You have to add up only these two. See, these questions, you need not ask me, you need to, I have only these two waveforms, how do I do? Add them up, what you will get? What you will get? What you will get? Yeah, column, you add this too. What do you get? He is talking about only this, I know. Isn't it? This is what he is talking about. But he wants, using two, he wants more level. That's what your question. That I don't know. Going against the law of nature, I don't know. I don't know. That you have to find out.